A very good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the sixth episode of our season 2023 of Decide Meetup, powered by IxDF Kerala and co-sponsored by Experian Technologies. Our speaker, Kannan, will be taking us through UI design patterns. Over to you, Kannan.
Hello and good evening, everyone, and welcome to this IxDF session on user interface design patterns. So today we will be discussing the importance of using design patterns in creating effective and user-friendly interfaces. Let's consider if there is a solution you are trying to design for your users, whether you are designing wireframes or the UI for a specific product. Chances are flaws and problems you are working on have already been designed and tested by other designers in other products before. Some of the examples would include login flows, user onboarding, date pickers, chat interactions, image uploading, etc. So these best practices are documented in the form of design patterns, which are just use cases of familiar, repeatable, and recurring ways of designing solutions that address common problems we find in design digital software solutions. So when it comes to designing a brand new innovative UI design project, exploring these UI design patterns could spark creativity and innovation in your own design process. By referring these existing patterns, you may discover new ways to adapt and evolve them to suit unique design challenges. So in this presentation, we will be exploring the world of UI design patterns, defining their significance, benefits, and also some real-world applications. We will be looking into the introduction, followed by understanding what user interface design patterns are and why they are such powerful design aids for us, the designers. We will also be going through the types of UI patterns, some of the best practices to use them, and also various popular examples. So user interface design patterns are just pre-established solutions to common design problems. These patterns are created by experienced designers who have encountered similar problems in their work and have found successful solutions. These design patterns are just powerful tools which helps providing solutions to common design challenges, guiding designers in creating interfaces that are not only aesthetically pleasing, but also efficient and also user-friendly. Design patterns helps designers save time and also effort by providing a set of guidelines for solving common design problems. They also helps in ensuring consistency and also usability across interfaces, making them easier for users to navigate and also interact with the interface. So let's consider a mobile app for a travel booking platform. In a travel booking app, we could see several design patterns are used to enhance the user experience and also streamline the booking process. First, we could consider the welcome screen. So welcome screens usually helps to provide a warm and also inviting introduction to the app that we are going to use. It usually displays a captivating background image. So in this case, it's something related to travel, accompanied by a brief headline and also a concise description that communicates the app's purpose and also value proposition. Here, the screens also helps in showcasing the app's key features related to travel booking. So each of the screen should include a clear call to action button which will prompt the users to proceed to the next screen or continue with the onboarding process. Then we have the tabbed navigation, which is a design pattern which allows users to switch between different sections of the app, such as home, favorites, profile, etc., using these tabs. So this will help in providing a clear and organized way to navigate between different types of options within the pane. Then we have card-based layouts. So card-based layout patterns present search results, popular hotel listings, and also hot deals as individual cards. So each of these cards will contain the essential information such as the price, ratings, and also the key details, which helps in allowing users to quickly view and compare options. Next, we have the calendar picker, which is simply a pattern which provides a user-friendly interface for selecting the travel dates. So users can tap on the calendar icon to view the calendar and also choose their desired departure and also return dates, making them easier to plan their trips. So UI design patterns are just reusable or recurring components which designers use to solve common problems in a user interface designing. So these patterns are just standardized solutions to common design problems, helping in creating user interfaces. These patterns are already established and proven over time, drawing from user research, usability studies, and also industry best practices. So they help in providing designers with a set of guidelines and principles to follow when crafting an interface, which helps in enabling them to create intuitive, consistent, and also efficient user experiences. These UI design patterns cover a wide range of elements and interactions, including navigation menus, form layouts, content organization, and also interaction feedback. So as designers, by utilizing these patterns, we could streamline the design process, enhance usability, and also improve user satisfaction. In addition to this, design patterns foster familiarity and also ease of use for users as they encounter similar interface elements and also interactions across different applications and websites. Ultimately, UI design patterns serves as valuable tools in designing interfaces that not only look visually appealing, but also provide seamless and delightful user experiences. For example, the breadcrumb design pattern lets users retrace their steps. So as designers, we could use them to a broad range of cases, but each of them must adapt to the specific context of use. So websites and apps have a conventional look and feel because of these design patterns, such as the global navigation and the tab bars we see in the day-to-day apps and websites we use. So in UI design, you can use design patterns as a quick way to build interfaces that solve a problem. For instance, a date picker design pattern, which we have seen in the previous travel booking app, lets users to quickly pick a date in a form. So UI design pattern serves as a design blueprint, which allows designers to choose the best and also commonly used interfaces for specific context the user faces. These patterns also provide ready-made solutions to common design problems. They offer a structured approach and guidelines, saving designers time and also effort in reinventing the wheel for every design challenge. So by leveraging these design patterns, designers could streamline their workflow and also focus on other aspects of the design process. These patterns have been extensively tested and also refined based on user feedback and also research. So what they do is they will incorporate established usability principles, ensuring that the resulting interfaces are intuitive and also user-friendly. By utilizing these design patterns, designers could create interfaces that align with the user expectations, leading to enhanced user experience and also customer satisfaction. These patterns also promote consistency in interface design. By using commonly used recognized patterns, designers could create interfaces that users are already familiar with. Also, the consistency in these design elements, interactions, and also navigation fosters a sense of familiarity, reducing the learning curve for users and also enabling them to navigate through the interfaces easily and quickly. These patterns often address specific design challenges, offering effective solutions to common problems. They provide a structured way of approaching design issues and also help designers make informed decisions. Design patterns also encourage best practices and also prevent common usability pitfalls, resulting in a more efficient and a well-designed interfaces. While design patterns provide guidance, they are not rigid templates. They could be customized and adapted to fit specific project requirements and also design goals. These patterns offer a starting point, allowing designers to build upon and innovate within the framework they provide. This flexibility ensures that design patterns can be applied to a wide range of projects while still allowing for individual creativity and also unique design solutions. In summary, design patterns are powerful aids in design process because they offer efficiency, usability, consistency, and also problem-solving capabilities. By leveraging design patterns, designers could create interfaces that are well-crafted, user-friendly, and also deliver a superior user experience. So there are several types of user interface design patterns, including navigation patterns, input patterns, and layout patterns. These patterns helps in facilitating usability and also making it easier for users to understand and navigate through the interfaces. So some of the popular UI designs patterns are navigation patterns, input patterns, feedback patterns, followed by social patterns and also onboarding patterns. So first we can take a look at the navigation patterns. So these patterns define how users move between different sections or pages of an application. Some of the common navigation patterns are, first one is the sidebar navigation, so which is a vertically straight bar at the left side of the interface, which usually contains a list of options or categories. So this one is an example of a three-tier sidebar navigation. Next, we have tabs, which allows users to switch between different views or sections within a single screen. Followed by the accordion, which is simply a vertically stacked list of items, where clicking on one item expands its content while it will collapse the others. Next, we have input patterns, which are patterns which defines how users provide input or interact with UI elements. Some of the common input patterns include forms, which are usually used to collect user input, such as registration forms or search forms. Then we have the dropdown, which is a list of options that appears when a user clicks on a field, allowing them to select one option. Then we have the date picker, which is simply a widget that enables users to select a date from a calendar. Next, we have feedback patterns. So these patterns provide visual cues and feedback to users to communicate the status or the outcome of their actions in the UI design. So first we have toast notifications, which is just temporary non-intrusive notifications that would appear to provide feedback on an action that a user performed. Then we have progress indicators, which are just visual elements that showcases the progress of a task or any loading process which is happening. Then we have error messages, which are clear messages that informs the users about any errors or invalid input they have made. Next, we have social patterns. So social patterns are patterns which focus on social interactions within an application. So some of the social patterns would include, first one is user profile, which is a page or a section that displays information about a user, maybe such as their name or photo or maybe bio or anything, any information related to the user. Then we have the activity streams, which are simply the chronological display of recent activities or updates from any users or a group. Then we have the likes and comment, which are just interactive elements that allows users to express their feedback or engage in discussions through the UI. Next, we have onboarding patterns. So onboarding patterns are used to introduce new users to an application and also guide them through its features. Some of the common onboarding patterns, first one is tutorials. So tutorials are just screens or step-by-step guides that provides instructions on how to use different features within an application or a software. Then we have the welcome screen, which is a screen that greets users and also provide an overview of the application's purpose. Then we have user onboarding flows, which are just guided flows that helps users set up their profile or customize their experience. So each of these type of patterns serves a specific purpose and also can be used in different ways to create effective interfaces. So as designers, by understanding the different types of patterns and how they work, we can choose the right pattern for a particular interface and also create a more user-friendly experience. So those were just a few examples of the UI design patterns. There are many more patterns available, and also designers often combine or modify them to suit the specific needs of their application. So it is important to note that while design patterns can be helpful, they should not be applied blindly. So each of these applications and its users have unique requirements. So designers should consider the context and also the purpose of their design while applying these patterns. Before applying UI design patterns, thoroughly understand the specific needs and also goals of the target users. Tailor the patterns to match their preferences and behaviors for creating a more effective UI design. Next is to consider the context of the application or website. So design patterns should be adapted and also customized to fit seamlessly within your unique interface and also its brand identity, rather than just applying them blindly. Always make sure to maintain consistency throughout your interface by using design patterns consistently. Consistent patterns create a sense of familiarity and also predictability, making it easier for users to navigate and understand your interface. Also, design patterns are not meant to be used in isolation. Combine them thoughtfully and also purposefully to create a cohesive and also intuitive user experience. Try to avoid cluttering your interface with too many patterns, as it can lead to confusion and cognitive overload. Then comes user testing, which is a critical to validate the effectiveness of UI design patterns. Conduct usability tests and also gather feedback to identify any issues or areas for improvement. Then iterate and refine your designs based on user insights to enhance the overall user experience of the software. Always remember to stay updated. These UI design patterns evolve over time, and also it is essential to stay up to date with the latest trends and also the best practices. So try to regularly explore industry resources, attend conferences, and also engage with the design community to stay informed and continuously improve your design skills. So let's take a look at some of the examples of widely popular interfaces which effectively uses these user interface design patterns. The first example is the Google search bar, which simply uses an input pattern to allow users to search for information. Next, we have Amazon product page, which uses a layout pattern to organize product information and reviews. Similarly, in the Facebook app, the users may navigate between the home, watch, marketplace, notifications, and the menu areas using the bottom navigation bar. Also, the Facebook scrollable news feed displays posts, pictures, and also videos using a card-based system, which is a common design pattern. Next one is Instagram. So similar to what we have seen in Facebook, users using the Instagram app also can navigate between the home, feed, explore, etc. in the using the bottom navigation bar. So Instagram also uses a hamburger menu in the top left corner to give users to a number of features such as user profile, settings, and also saved content. So another example is WhatsApp. So in WhatsApp, a new chat or a conversation can be started with contacts in our list using WhatsApp's floating action button. So WhatsApp displays individual chat discussions as chat bubbles, allowing users to view and respond to messages without navigating away from the current screen. So these examples demonstrate how user interface design patterns could be used in different ways to create effective and also user-friendly interfaces. As designers, by studying these examples, we could gain inspiration for our own designs and also learn how to use patterns in creative and also effective ways. So since these patterns are freely available, UI design patterns lets you save time and also money, since you can copy and adapt them into your design instead of just starting from scratch for designing every new interface. So when working with design patterns in UI design, it's crucial to approach them with care and also consideration. Always prioritize the needs and also preferences of the users. While these design patterns can provide guidance, they should be adapted and also customized to best serve your specific user base and also context. Always consider the unique characteristics of your application or the website, because not all design patterns will be appropriate or effective for every situation. Evaluate the suitability of each pattern based on the goals, content, and also functionality of the interface you are trying to build. Design patterns should enhance the user experience, but using them excessively or indiscriminately could lead to a monotonous and predictable interface. Always try to select and apply patterns judiciously, ensuring they serve a clear purpose and add value to the user's interaction. Always try to remember these design patterns are just tools to aid your design process, but they should not dictate or limit your creativity. Try to use them as a starting point and adapt them to suit your specific needs and objectives. Always considering the unique characteristics of your users and context, try to design the user interfaces effectively. So in conclusion, UI design patterns serve as valuable resources in creating intuitive, user-friendly interfaces. They provide a foundation of proven solutions and best practices that would streamline the design process and also enhance the user experience. By leveraging design patterns effectively, us designers could improve consistency, usability, and also familiarity in our interfaces, resulting in creating a more seamless and also enjoyable interaction for our users. However, it is important to approach design patterns with care. Adapting and customizing these design patterns to meet the unique needs and also context of each project is important. The user-centered mindset, continuous iteration, and also a balance of consistency and innovation. These UI design patterns can be powerful tools in crafting interfaces that delight and engage users. Furthermore, UI design patterns should not be seen as rigid templates, but rather as starting points for creativity and also innovation. While these patterns help us provide guidance, it is also essential to embrace flexibility and also customization to match the unique brand identity and also user requirements. We designers should continuously test and iterate on these designs, seeking user feedback and also making necessary adjustments required. In addition to all this, staying informed about the latest trends and also emerging patterns ensures that design should remain current and also aligned with evolving user expectations. So by combining the practicality of these design patterns with a willingness to push boundary and adapt, we designers could create interfaces that not only stick to best practices, but also offer delightful and memorable user experiences. So thank you for investing your time and attention to learn about the significance and also applications of UI design patterns. So I hope these insights shared today would have inspired and also will empower you to make use of these powerful design aids in your design projects. So I encourage you to continue exploring and also implement these design patterns in your work. Try to use their efficiency, consistency, and also problem-solving capabilities to enhance your designs and also create exceptional user experiences. So once again, thank you for being part of this session.
Thank you. Thank you, Kannan, for taking us through user interface design patterns. And this was very informative and useful for me. Okay, let's move on the Q&A session. Please feel free to unmute yourself and ask questions or type in the chat window. As well as you can also share your feedback or your own experience related to this topic. If anyone has any experience or questions, please feel free to ask here.
Hello, hi, Kannan.
Yeah. Hi.
Hello.
Yeah, this is Vandana. Do you have any advice for, UI designers who are just starting their career in UI and probably want to learn more about these things, about design patterns, what are ideal patterns for each of these whatever you covered?
Yeah, so there are many resources available. I will just share some of. So there are probably websites that showcases these design patterns. So we could just use them to use as our references to create our kind of design patterns. So one is Design Vault. So in Design Vault, you could see there are a plenty of available resources for UI design patterns available. We have a separate tab for UI patterns. So you could just refer these websites and also find the effective required pattern which you need to work on for your project. There is another one called Mobin, which is also a collection of just the screens. So you could just go through any of the popular applications. A lot of collection is available. Almost all famous apps we could see within this website. So we could use these screens also. Then we have a dedicated website called UI Patterns. So this also helps in understanding more about the user interface design patterns and how to use them effectively within your design projects. So I think I will drop a more list of these kind of resources in the chat window.
Thank you, Kannan.
Thank you. Thank you, Vandana. Any questions?
Hi, Kannan. It's me, Nandu.
Okay.
I have one question. How can designers effectively balance creativity and consistency when implementing UI patterns?
Okay. So in order to effectively use these patterns, the first primary thing to do is to understand the purpose of the app or the software that we are like trying to design. So this understanding usually will provide a solid foundation in order for the creative adaptations while referring through these design patterns. Also, always try to like stick to the brand identity. So maintaining consistency is more important. So while considering these patterns, always try to consider the brand identity too. The final one is to just iterate and refine. So these patterns could be used as these templates for our reference, and according to our needs and the user's specific needs, we should prioritize and adapt these reference patterns and should iterate and improve. So that's it.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Nandu. The question. Okay, any other?
Hey, hi, Kannan. Siddharth is it. So my question is for you is how you validate your decision while doing the pattern and all, I mean, whatever you are doing, how you validate in the process?
Excuse me, can you repeat the question, sir?
While using UI pattern, how you validate everything in the process that this is going good, this is going bad, or something?
Okay.
And also is add on question, which app you think it's according to you it's having a nice US, any app you can as example you can say like it's good as UI pattern, whatever you gone through any app. Like let's say for WhatsApp, Instagram, and
most of the apps that we use in daily life, the login patterns, the onboarding screens, etc. So everything is an example for what this UI design patterns. For example, let's say we have in mobile the example I mentioned earlier. So we could see the screens here. So the initial onboarding screens, this login, sign up, everything that we use commonly in all the applications that we go through, those are examples of these design patterns. So the common sign up flow, registration, everything we see is somewhat like similar to each other, right? So that's what we find in almost all the applications that we daily use. So that's what.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Kannan.
Thank you. So Kannan, hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay. Kannan, how can I the UI patterns enhance the overall user experience and the usability of an application? That's my question actually.
Okay, the basic thing is these patterns will help provide a consistency and also some familiar design elements when we interact with the app or software that we are using. Mm-hmm. So this consistency is the main thing that it will make easier for the users who are using these applications, and also makes them easy to navigate through the interface that we have created. And also it will help in improving the efficiency and also the speed by which customers use our application. So since they are familiar with the patterns that they find in almost all the similar applications they use, so it will help in reducing the time they use to find solutions through our interfaces that we have. Next one is also the consistency, which is also another thing which I mentioned in the last question's answer also. So it will be consistent, almost all the design elements that we find will be consistent on. It will help the user to create a better user experience.
Okay. Hi,
Kannan.
Hello.
Nikhil here. I have a question. So these design patterns, do you document it in the design system or do you document it somewhere else?
You can you explain once again this?
How do you document these design patterns? Do you do it in the design system itself?
We can usually document it in the design system. So most of the common design patterns are already freely available all over the internet and all, or maybe some of the reference sites which I mentioned. So others, when we are creating a new like user pattern or design pattern, I mentioned, so we could document it within the design system.
Okay, so it's the same document to document. Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions? So anyone can share the experience.
Yeah, I do have one question.
Yeah.
So Kannan, all these points are great. If we incorporate in our work, it's going to be very much efficient and time saving. I'd like to know from your experience that has it been a situation that not following this process has costed you a lot of rework and difficulty in handling a situation? I mean, when things don't go well, have you ever faced such a situation? Because just to reinforce the thought, like what could really go wrong if we don't do this, then what are the consequences?
Okay, so the one way is to create some more easier pattern than the existing one. So that could be if we are trying to make or create a pattern by rebuilding some of the existing pattern we have. So it should be more easier than the existing one. If that is the situation, then it's fine. So otherwise, we would be like forced to go back to the existing pattern itself. So that's what I had in my experience.
Got it.
Okay. We have one question from the chat window. Himanshi Puri. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
He asked, can you tell me about the courses or colleges for people who are new to the field of UI UX? I will give the next year, but till then, what should I do? This question from Himanshi Puri. Yeah. Hello. Kannan?
Yes. Regarding the courses, right? Regarding UI design courses, right?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay. So regarding courses, I think there are like many like courses you can be available in the interaction design foundation itself. Mm-hmm. So regarding the institutes and all, I think you need to like just have a research on the net and all. So.
Okay, another question from Nikhil. Does choosing colors for the UI also come under UI design patterns?
So there are some, according to color theory and all, there are some patterns that usually follows based on the color theory also. So that could also be considered as some of the design patterns because there are like various meanings for each of the colors within the color wheel and all, which comes under the color theory and which is also important part of this patterns. Mm-hmm. So it could also be considered as some of the design, usually used design patterns, etc. So for a warning, everything we use the red color and also for positive accept and all we use green color. So green everything color. Everything comes under the patterns itself.
Okay. Any other experience or questions? Okay. If anyone has any experience or questions, please ask.
Surely. Hi, Vaishnav here.
Hi, Vaishnav.
Yeah, just one thing to highlight, since we are talking about patterns, it's from a psychological point of view. One thing, as you said, it reduces, there are many pros for it. That's the thing. Patterns are, you know, easy to implement and easy to understand. And as you pointed out, it will be easy to remember for the user also. But also from the psychological point of view, once the user is adapted to it, once a great amount of users are adapted to it, it will be really difficult to make changes to that particular pattern. So imagine if Amazon suddenly decides to, change a little bit of, make a small variation, say in their add to cart button. So that's going to change a lot of dynamics throughout the entire platform. So that is one thing I want to highlight. Good pros. That's the thing about patterns, right? So once you get used to it, it's really difficult to adapt to something new.
Yeah.
Thank you, Vaishnav, for your experience.
I think just adding to what Vaishnav was saying, what some companies or products do or applications, I think is make subtle changes instead of an entire complete change to that experience or that action or, the interface. They make subtle changes and over time, then they so the user gets time to actually adapt slowly. But like, yeah, I absolutely agree with an absolute change in the entire pattern. For example, even introducing, if it's an HR tool for employees, and then completely changing an entire tool and an entire experience, it takes a lot of time, I think, for the users to get used to it and adapt to it.
Yes.
Thanks, Kannan. It was a great session. I really liked your presentation and everything. It was very interesting.
Thank you, Anthony. Okay. Anyway, once again, thank you so much, Kannan, for taking time for us and bringing us the interesting session. And I would like to thank each and everyone who left their valuable time from a busy day to attend this webinar. And thank you to all the volunteers of the IxDF team that worked behind the scenes to make this even happen. Please write to us and let us know how you found the session. We are available on social media like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Clubhouse at IxDF Kerala. You can also write to us, idfkerala@hotmail.com. And we have an exclusive IxDF Kerala community in the Interaction Design Foundation website. Hope to see you on the next session. We come to you with another webinar. Stay safe and stay tuned. Thank you.